campaign knew these claims of voter fraud were false, yet they continued to barrage small-dollar donors with emails, encouraging them to donate to something called the Official Election Defense Fund. The Select Committee discovered no such fund existed.
I don't believe there is actually a fund called the Election Defense Fund.
Is it fair to say the Election Defense Fund was another, as I think we've called it, a marketing tactic?
Yes.
And tell us about these funds as marketing tactics.
Just topic matter.
You know, now look, it's up to you to what extent you think the revelations about exactly how much the Trump campaign conned their own followers following the election of 2020, how important that is in comparison to the goal of all of that, which was not just to enrich themselves, but to contradict the will of the voters and remain as president when that's not what the American people wanted. These are two very significant things. I would argue the end of democracy is more important, but the wholesale scam that was run following the election was put on full display in the most recent hearings of the January 6th committee. They revealed that this supposed fund that they were raising money for to contest the election results raised $250 million. That was not what they raised for the election in advance. That would be a huge amount of money. No, that's what they raised after the election, supposedly to make sure that the fraud was revealed, but that was never the intention, and that's not what they did with the money. They put the money into this Save America PAC. They made contributions to Mark Meadows' charity that has something to do, I guess, with election fraud, to a conservative organization employing former Trump staffers, to the Trump Hotel Collection, and to the company that organized the rally that preceded the attack on the Capitol. And in that video, you saw Amanda Wick, who's a lawyer who's working with the January 6th committee. She said the emails, because they focus on these massive text and email blasts that were going out every single day to Trump followers, said they continued through January 6th, even as Trump gave his speech that morning, 30 minutes after the last fundraising email was sent, the Capitol was breached. So they had spent at that point like close to 10 weeks fundraising $250 million with no intention that it would go towards what they said. It was just topic matter. It was a marketing tactic to get money out of their credulous followers. What do you think, Yasmin?
Yeah, things like this, whenever they're revealed in something like the January 6th hearing, like what we're all seeing now, we're all watching this as a nation. We all know, all of us here watching this show right now, we all know that Donald Trump is a grifter, and we know that he's a liar, and we know that he'll say whatever he needs to say to, you know, reach whatever end he's trying to get to. But the thing that what it comes down to is trust, right, amongst his own base. Why do these people still trust him? Why do they still give him money after we all know that he's a liar and a grifter? Even if they're slow to come to that conclusion, now the evidence is there before them, so they can't really deny it. You know, this is money that he was asking for, donations to support something that he knew was a lie. We have it on video that he was told repeatedly that none of this stuff was true. None of the stuff he was saying was true. All the things that he was telling his base that the money was going to go towards investigating, there was nothing to investigate, right? We all know that now. It's their money that he took. And it would be interesting to see if any of that makes a dent in how they feel about him, you know, whether or not they decide to continue trusting him in the future now that there's this indisputable evidence. Really, frankly, I mean, it's on video. You can't argue with it.
If I could bet, I'd bet it's not going to get through to them. Look, get you a following that loves being conned the way they love being. Man, these people love being ripped off by Donald Trump. I mean, it's rare enough that the individual people who were worst ripped off even have an issue. So I saw people in the chat who were mentioning one of the things that they did to raise money that we did a lot of coverage on this at the time is, and by the way, Trump was not the only person who did this. He was maybe the worst, was setting people up fairly dishonestly for automatic payments to his PAC or whatever. And not small amounts of money. Sure, many of these donations were small, as we'll get to, but some people were having $600, $1,000, $2,000 being automatically deducted from their accounts, and they had no idea why. The Trump campaign ended up having to give back millions of dollars because of this. And if you're a conservative, you're watching this, I know that politics to you is just wanting the libs to get owned. You have no hope or faith that your lot in life will ever improve because you understand on some base level that politicians don't care about you and they're not gonna do anything, including the politicians that you support. And so the only thing that you can hope for is that people you don't like will do poorly, that they will be made to feel pain. Those are not the people who are being conned though, you idiots. You're the ones who are being robbed here. He raised $250 million. You'll notice he's not president. So where did the $250 million go? Well, you know where it went to. It went to paying off his friends and his lackeys and mostly him. He's saving this money so he can feel influential and big and maybe put it towards a future run. And maybe to you, that's enough, but it definitely didn't go to what they said it was going to. And Zoe Lofgren, who's a member of the January 6th committee, who was really helping to articulate this argument about the big con side of the big lie, said in an interview, well, people were conned by the former president. They were conned into believing that the election had been stolen and that they should go to the Capitol as the president asked them to. I think the average donation from those emails, false email requests, was something like $17. These were people that weren't rich people. They were conned by the president, whose big lie was also a big ripoff. And look, certainly many of the people who went to January 6th, I mean, there's people who took private jets. And look, if you can take off that much time to fly across the country, you're not, you know, the worst off in the world. But there were a lot of people that gave the little amount of money that they had, people who were actually struggling. And Donald Trump doesn't care. He's a multi-billionaire. If it cost $250 million to fight election fraud, which it doesn't, he could pay for it himself. He could do all this. He never needs to raise money off these people because he's so wealthy. But the fact that he cons them, the fact that he so rarely is willing to put his own money where his ambitions are, I don't get it, Yasmin. I don't get why that doesn't bother them more.
I mean, there's a whole subset of YouTube that I sometimes get stuck in, and it's people who expose other grifters on the internet. And most of these people are like online people, Instagram models or whatever they're promoting, and people just give them all their money and they'll do a lot of these same tactics. You know, like they'll kind of create a problem and then offer a solution that people then need to pay to access. And then they'll do the thing with the recurring payment so people don't even realize how much of their money they're giving to these people and to these causes. And Donald Trump is doing all of these same things to these people. And unfortunately, hopefully now they're a little bit more informed. But you know, back then, I mean, people are really easy to get conned into these things because they don't really understand the systems that are being used against them. Hopefully now with the hearing, that will be remedied a little bit. But like you said, I mean, who knows if it'll actually make a difference with these people.
Yeah. Who knows? And look, I acknowledge you. Some of you might be aware there's a particular kink of being financially dominated. Some people are into that. They like someone who just takes all of their money. But at least that's generally an open thing. They understand what they're getting into. Don't fall into that trap politically. Don't. By the way, it's not just Trump. Like the Democrats, we criticize them all the time for seeming to think that every crisis, every major issue in America is just there to do email blasts about. Don't do anything. Don't lower the chance that the same sort of crisis happens again. Just raise money off of it. Like, sure, your reproductive rights are about to be stripped away, but I think this is an opportunity to raise some money. They do that too. At least in theory, if they could vote in a way, they would. Maybe Trump, no intention whatsoever. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.